Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Connect. My name is Adrian Fernandez and I'm joined by Daniel Ogilvie from our LaunchPad applications team to talk about a brand new product called the LaunchPad SensorTag Kit. So thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, super pumped to talk about this brand new tool, the LPSTK. Could you maybe give a quick introduction as to what it is?
Sure. So the thought behind this was we wanted to take the LaunchPad kit, make it into a more compact format, add some sensors on board, add battery power, and fully enclose it just to make development that much more streamlined, quick, and easy. So it's part of the LaunchPad ecosystem, but fully enclosed, really fun kit to work with.
Awesome. So walk through some of the onboard sensors. You know, what kind of capability do I get out of the box?
Sure. So in terms of sensing, we have mostly environmental sensors.
Okay.
First one is temperature and humidity. So that is managed by our HTC 2080. Then we have ambient light with the OPT 3001. We have a Hall effect sensor with the DRV 5032, as well as an accelerometer, a super low power accelerometer.
Wow. So lots of ability to understand the environment around you.
Exactly.
And then obviously various forms of connectivity integrated into this as well.
Right. So we're using the CC1352R device. So that has both sub 1 gigahertz and 2.4 gigahertz capabilities built in.
Okay.
So on the board, you can see we have a PCB antenna for 2.4 gigahertz mm-hmm. and this external antenna for sub 1 gigahertz.
Wow. And are those frequencies something I can operate simultaneously within my application?
Yeah, great question. So you can. We have a feature called DMM that allows you to timeshare between multiple stacks.
Okay.
And so some of the examples we have for this kit actually use 2.4 gigahertz with BLE to communicate to a phone. As well as sub 1 gigahertz to communicate over long range, low power
wow,
networks.
Wow, that's awesome. So you kind of get the best of both worlds,
exactly.
Kind of the long range of sub 1 gigahertz, but the accessibility of 2.4.
That's right.
Awesome. And power options. Looks like this guy's operating here. What options are available to developers?
Sure. So kind of out of the box, it supports AAA batteries. But we also have the option to add a coin cell holder to the back in case you want to operate it off of a 2032 coin cell battery.
Okay, nice. And then you mentioned this being part of the LaunchPad ecosystem,
right.
And it looks vaguely like a LaunchPad. I know these connectors pretty well from other LaunchPad kits that
yeah.
we have in our portfolio. What does that give developers?
Yeah, so we went ahead and included the LaunchPad connectors on this board, so you can extend functionality through booster packs. So you could add things like displays. If you wanted sensors that aren't available on the kit, you could easily add those, or even wire up your custom circuit to the board.
Gotcha, so it's super extendable from a hardware
exactly.
perspective.
Yes.
Love it. And I know you've got a demo here ready to go. Really excited to see it.
Yeah.
Here we'll be demonstrating, I guess, Bluetooth connectivity today.
Right. So this is the out-of-box image. This is what comes programmed on the kit when you first power it on.
Okay.
So what we're going to use is the SimpleLink starter app. It's available on iOS and Android. And what it's going to do is connect to the device and then stream sensor data to the mobile device.
Okay. Awesome. Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah. So all we have to do is in the app, select our LaunchPad SensorTag kit, and then we're going to click sensor view. And what that's going to do is allow us to view the values for all the sensors on board. So we can see ambient light, humidity, ambient temperature. We can control the LEDs on the LaunchPad sensor tag from the mobile app. We can toggle those
okay,
on and off.
Nice.
We can also view sensor button presses. So in the app, we can see when we're pressing a button on the kit. So just kind of showing that communication back and forth.
Love it.
One other great feature in the app is we can push this data to the cloud. So we can use our phone as a gateway.
Okay.
And then finally, we are able to do over-the-air downloads, so programming new images onto the device using
awesome.
The mobile app over
okay.
BLE.
So that means I don't need to hook this up over USB to my laptop. I can
Correct.
Get new images by simply programming it over the Bluetooth connection.
That's right. So at launch, we're going to have three examples specifically designed for the LPSTK. So we'll have one example where we're using the LPSTK as a Zigbee light switch.
Okay.
We'll have another example where we're using the LPSTK as a sensor node in a 15.4 network. And then the example we're doing right now with the out-of-box sensor streaming.
Love it, love it. And then also, I guess from an SDK perspective, you know, while those are the kind of primary use cases, there's other examples available to developers
right.
as well.
So we kept this as schematically identical to the original LaunchPad as we could. So any of the SDK examples for the 1352 LaunchPad will also run on the LaunchPad sensor tag
kit.
That's
incredible. Very cool. Well, I appreciate the demo here, Daniel. And from a getting started perspective, where can developers go to get this documentation?
So best place to get started is dev.ta.com/LPSTK.
Awesome. Very cool. Well, Daniel, I'm excited to play with this tool. Hopefully you guys are as well. You can learn more at dev.ta.com/LPSTK, as Daniel mentioned, and we can't wait to see what developers do with this brand new tool. And also, if you want to tune in next week, we obviously have other SimpleLink experts to join us to talk about brand new products and technologies. So be sure to tune in next week, and we'll catch you guys next time. Thank you so much.